This is the house of Henry Van Helm. Located in the snowy suburbs of Fitzholm in the Republic of Kranzburg. 482 square feet in area. Complete with a full library of poetry, nonfiction, and political economics. Equipped with a basement cold room primarily to support Van Helm's healthy love of apples. His life has an incredibly consistent daily schedule and routine. At breakfast, he eats 3/4 cup of Fitzholm steel-cut oats, 1/2 cup of whole milk, 1/3 cup of chopped apples, and 1/8 teaspoon of cinnamon. What does he do? He writes a daily column for the Fitzholm Times, featured on the front page. He provides unique commentary on the economic situation in Kranzburg, with the occasional short film review. In the afternoon, he reads classics and nonfiction. Above the fireplace sits one of Van Helm's most prized possessions, an original painting of a Fitzholmian finch, given to him from the ambassador to Zabroska. However, there were those who coveted his prize painting.
What the heck?
Dear brother, I have your prize painting. Publicly declare that I am the superior writer, and it shall be returned. Sincerely, Carl.
The thief was none other than his brother and writing competition, Carl Van Helm, who writes a male fashion column for the morning Fitzholm.
Dear brother, I adamantly refuse. Your inconsequential demands are only outmatched by the irrelevance of your daily column. Truly, Henry.
Dear brother, your words are as empty as your cold heart. Submit to my demands or I will throw your finch in the fireplace. Sincerely, Carl.
Dear brother, your childish attempt to prove yourself is the reason that mother lost the will to live. Truly, Henry.
Dear Henry, you are no longer family. You are dead to me. Sincerely, Carl.
Driven by rage, Carl sought his brother's life. He hired one of Fitzholm's most notorious assassins to take care of his brother. However, Henry expected this.
I've been expecting this.
As a final request, he asked the assassin to deliver a message to his brother.
Dear Carl, your man happens to be a huge fan of my film reviews. I'm afraid he's taken my side. Enjoy your last few moments of life. Truly, Henry.